here, there are a few things about this. Okay, so the start, you said it's this yellow car, you see this one. This is a really fast car. From my experience, if I let it in front of me, it flies away really, really fast. But also, this is by far my best couple of laps. And some laps I made some mistakes as well. So it's possible, I think, to beat it without getting ahead of it. Alright, also, turn it. How you take this one? I'm up high, and I'm aiming for that, like where the front runner right now, I'm aiming for that apex. If you look at the front runner and you, in your mind, draw a line to the white circuit limits, this is where I'm aiming. Throttle very carefully. You can see, just slight lifts, you can see like the lifts are very slight. So I end up ahead of this guy, and he bumps me on top of the sea. This corner, this is the slowest car I've seen this year. Bump it on something different. Not extremely showy so far. So here, obviously, you go straight down, you lift a little bit, you want to go up high, you want to meet the angles, and then you want to position the PC. You position your car so it's a bit to the left, and what it actually does, I hope this is a correct example. What it actually does is that your both of your nose is a bit lower than your ear, and that, in this game at least, I'm not a big oval guy, makes the car a bit more stable, makes it more pointy. But I guess it makes sense because the cars are very at a different. The car wheels left and right are at a different height when you're going along the grass. But if not grass. Glass. Let me rephrase it. If you're going on an oval in a straight line, well, in a circle in an oval, your left hand wheels are a lot lower than your right hand wheels. But if you would position the car perpendicularly to the track, your wheels would be on the same lateral. Your left and right wheels will be on the same height. It's your front and rears that would be different height, but that's irrelevant for talking about traction. So by rotating the car slightly to the left here, I'm making sure that the difference between my left hand wheels and right hand wheels is lower than it otherwise would, and it does make a difference. So here I can switch from the leg and the leg and the leg and the leg, which hit flat out or switch. And here it's pretty straightforward. I think you can take this corner faster or slower. Actually, this is but I'm not gonna go towards the next lap to talk about this corner. This corner is simple. All you need to do is to carefully apply throttle so you have a comfortable speed. There is no trickery to that corner. As long as you take it as calm as possible, you'll be faster. Like you can go in faster, you can like slide a bit and hold the slide and whatever, but I think it also slows you down. I think this way is the quickest. Just dab, don't go on the inside, don't go on the black line there, stay in the white half of the track, and you know, comfortable, no understeer, no oversteer, comfortable dab for brakes, and then comfortable throttle modulation. And I can't tell you how to modulate the throttle, I showed you a bit of telemetry, but you know, it's really just something that's gonna come with experience. So, yeah, thank you for watching.